What do you tell your patients about how their allergies and asthma are related to each other?
We know that asthma that develops in childhood is very often allergic asthma. And we might see this asthma develop in someone who has already had signs of other allergies. This might have been someone who, as a baby, had eczema or food allergies, and then went on to develop allergic rhinitis or nasal allergies. And then the asthma can go hand in hand with that. There are genetics playing a role in the background of this, just being more of an allergic person. But it's an important association to recognize. So if you are someone with both allergies and asthma, getting control of your allergies can actually help with your asthma care as well.
Do you recommend allergy testing in almost all your asthma patients, or do you do it in only certain patients?
So experts in this field have recommended that allergy testing be done for anyone with persistent asthma. Persistent asthma is asthma where symptoms are often enough that your doctor is recommending a controller medication for your asthma, everyday medication. And in these people, doing allergy testing can identify an important trigger.
I always find it fascinating how certain individuals have the allergies, but it stays confined to above the lung. I mean, they have nasal allergies, and then in certain individuals, the lungs get involved. And I'm sure there are some interesting genetics that are responsible for those differences.
Absolutely. And just our anatomy as well. If you're someone who is predisposed to asthma, we know that we often call this one airway, where behind your nose, the nasopharynx is connected to the tubes that go into your lungs. And if you have inflammation and allergy and swelling up in the upper part of this one airway, it can translate into inflammation in the lower part and trigger that asthma.